you know, you hang up the decorations in the gym, don't dance.
So I am from District 12. We've had growth, some losses, we're losing some schools, but we are trying to keep the morale kind of on a positive level with our parents right now. Like most have said on this end, parent involvement engagement has been a struggle this year. On a PTA level, as well as President's Council, our people aren't showing up. And it's been such a disconnect because it's like you have the same 8 parents. Our quorum by bylaws, as they've been, have been 11 parents. We haven't even had a quorum sometimes. So we are trying to see what can improve. I will say it now. Love you guys, but this is my last go around. I will not be on the President's Council of District 12 for the incoming school year. But I am still there to support my families and my parents, and they have my number. And so I'm still there, just without a title. So I will still come see you guys and visit, but I'll be sitting on the outskirts with anyone else, but those people.
I want to add some history to it. Currently in the high school person has spoken already. I just want a question, is there somebody from District 2 CEC that's here?
This question is now President Harris.
Yes, okay. When I was in elementary middle school, the CEC was represented.
That's right.
In terms of the CEC or the president.
But if she's not on CPAC, she doesn't want to be a teacher.
The word from District 2 is they don't need us. When we went to them, they said, we don't need you guys. There's no reason for us to come to Wake Forest. And that's part of the problem. The highly performing district, the high performing schools, they're like, we don't need, we don't need our curriculum. And then I'm quoting both the president and the FLC. Both said that to me. We do not need you. Thank you, District 2. I'm sorry.
Welcome to the high performing district 26. We're always here.
Thank you for that. And thank you for your work.
Before we go on, I'm going to send, since we can't seem to locate the sign-in sheet, I'm going to send a voting member sign-in sheet around again. So please sign even if you have already signed the other sheet.
I'll only sign by your name.
Yes.
This is an attendance sheet of individuals, not districts, because we need that for our elections in October, just to reiterate. Under the CPAC bylaws, you have to have a meeting for the previous year. And so we need to know that you, that person.
Good morning.
So I think you know me, I know you. So I understand we're going to do a little Q&A.
Yeah.
Is
this the first time
that you're Yes. Oh my goodness, I feel like I've seen so many of you on the ballot. This is the first time. Right? So welcome to Tweed Courthouse. I'm really excited to be here with you. Seeing you out in the community, so I feel good about that. But it's good to be here with you, and I look forward to these meetings as we go forward as well. As I've been out and about, I've heard from a lot of different folks. I've made it a point to meet with not only communities, but also with teachers, with administrators, with principals. I feel like I've been sitting with lots of different people. I'm now interviewing every single one of our superintendents, getting to know them a little better, what their focus areas of focus are. I've met with advocacy groups across the community, pretty interestingly. I'll meet with one advocacy group at 10 o'clock that will tell me, don't do this, 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 and this. And then I'll meet with another one at 12 o'clock that will say exactly the opposite, do this, 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 and this. But that's all part of the democratic process, and that's all part of education in our city. So it's actually been a really good experience. I'm not sure, I've been pretty shy about expressing my views out in the community. So I don't know if you follow it, if you do follow that, I'm sorry. But I think there's a real opportunity and a real need, quite frankly, to just be honest about the conversations. And not to use coded language. And when you see something, call it. And then have a conversation about it. Anybody here from District 15? You know how to throw a party, bro, that's what I do.